Hi everyone, my name is Stefan Burns. I'm a geophysicist with Geometrics, and today I'm joined by Exploration Instruments in ARM Geophysics here out of Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. And we're gonna show you how you can set up a 1D MASW survey using the Geode Seismographs that's sold by us at Geometrics.
Here to help guide us through the setup is professional geologist Ryan Brandon with ARM Geophysics.
ARM Geophysics likes to use the Geode Seismograph particularly because it's easy to set up, it's reliable, it's dependable, and rugged for using in a host of different field situations which we encounter on a daily basis. Sometimes a freshly mowed field, sometimes the bare rock face of a quarry bench, sometimes in a wooded area. So we like to have a device that we can depend on and we're familiar with and easy to set up no matter the situation or the particular seismic survey setup we're working with.
Once all the gear has been mobilized, a 1D active MASW survey can be set up to meet the requirements of the job. The length of the survey line should be about 2 times the depth of interest if not supplementing with passive MAM data, or equal to the depth of interest if supplementing with passive MAM data. For a site classification VS30 survey, this means a spread length of around 60 to 75 meters if performing active MASW only. For this training demonstration, since we collected active and passive data, we set up a shorter 46-meter survey line with 2-meter spacings and used 4.5 Hz vertical geophones. Once the survey line is set up, offense shots can be performed to generate the surface waves needed for analysis.
For 1D active MASW surveys with the Geode Seismograph, it's best practice to take shots on either end of your array, instead of biasing towards one side of your array. And it's also good practice to take those end shots at a distance of 10% and again at 20 to 30% of your target wavelength.
Each end shot generates a dispersion curve, and with SeisImager SW, the dispersion curves from multiple shots can be combined and averaged to create a final shear wave velocity geologic profile with the highest likelihood of being true and accurate to reality. The 1D active MASW method does not take long to perform, with most of the time for the survey being the setup and breakdown of the equipment. Therefore, it is best practice to complete more shots than less, and this is why we recommend completing 2 end shots on each end of the survey line.
So for a 1D MASW survey, we first of all always like to make sure we're testing our acquisition parameters for the site's specific characteristics before we move forward with the survey. But a good starting point can generally be an acquisition interval of about 0.25 to 0.5 milliseconds and a record length of around 1 second. However, you always want to be sure that you're capturing the entire data set across the entire length of the array before you settle on a record length. It's also recommended to stack your shots. Stacks of 3 or 5 can be typically okay, but again, always check your data in the field to make sure you've captured what you think you've captured. And as always, remember to take good notes of everything that you're doing in the field. Your distances, your shot locations, your file numbers, your acquisition parameters, all of that will be vital to have later on when you go back to do your processing.
A sledgehammer is used to generate the active surface waves needed, and to trigger the seismograph to record data, a hammer switch is used, taped against the back of the sledgehammer. The sledgehammer should weigh in between 8 to 16 pounds, and most importantly, it should be a weight that can be handled properly. When the sledgehammer hits the strike plate, surface waves are created while simultaneously triggering the seismograph to begin recording data. Strong, directly vertical blows to the strike plate create the best active surface wave data.
For shallower surveys, we're relying more on the high frequency data. The steel plate is usually sufficient up to a depth of about 30 meters or so. Anytime you want to get data below that and you really want to pull those lower frequencies out, the rubberized plate may be a choice for you.
This summarizes how to set up a 1D active MASW survey. Thank you for watching part 2 of this 1D MASW training series. Continue to part 3 to learn how to process 1D active MASW data using SeisImager SurfaceWave.